job, saved my little money, and Lord, I tried to pay all my bills, but it's still a burden on me. Say, Lord, but I've done everything that I can do about it. When you made it to that point, that's when you put it in God's
hands.
Amen? When you can't fix it, you got to give it to the man who can. Amen? After I've done all that I can, I'll just stand. Well, I'll stand on the word of God. I'm going to stand on his promise. Taking you way back. Probably haven't looked at this book in a good 10 years. through Genesis. Starting in verse 9, the Bible reads, "And the Lord God called unto Adam and said unto him, Where art thou? And he said, I heard thy voice in the garden, and I was afraid, because I was naked, and I hid myself. And he said, Who told you that you was naked? Hast thou eaten of the tree whereof I commanded thee that thou shouldest not eat? And the man said, Love this, the woman whom you gave to be with me, she gave me of the tree, and I did eat. And the Lord God said unto the woman, What is this that thou hast done? And the woman said, Love this, the serpent beguiled me, and I did eat. And the Lord said unto the serpent, Because thou hast done this, thou art cursed above all cattle and above every beast of the field. Upon thy belly shalt thou go, and dust shalt thou eat all the days of thy life." We're going to pause right there, and we're going to share with you suffering the consequence. Suffering. If you know anything about your life, everybody knows the story of Adam and Eve. There's a lot of it that you might have missed, a lot of it that you didn't read, a lot of it you don't know, but everybody knows the story of Adam and Eve. Even the unsaved know the story of Adam and Eve. See, the Bible says that at one point God placed man on this planet, and he placed him here by himself. But the Lord looked around and he said, you know what? It just ain't right that the man should be here without a proper companion. The first thing I would share with you is saying to God, it ain't right for us to find ourselves in a place where we lock ourselves away. But somebody ought to be listening. We ought not to lock ourselves up and turn away the affections and the relationships of other people in our lives. Hello, somebody. It is not good for us to lock ourselves, our emotions, our feelings, to lock them away and then hold them on the inside and not allow that we share them with somebody. And that's not my word, that's what God said. He said it just ain't right. And he said, therefore I will make for him a helpmeet. See, the reason you need other folk in your life is because other people help you to grow. Our interactions one with another help us to grow. Amen. Men become better men because of their interaction with other men.
All right.
Hello, somebody. A woman becomes a better and stronger woman when she interacts with others in her life. When we are left to have to figure this thing out with no help, with no assistance, we are weaker in what we do. So God said, I need you to have somebody with you. And then the scripture goes on and says again, if you read your Bible, God spoke with Adam and he told Adam, he said, Adam, you can have anything on this in the garden. You can eat anything that you desire, except, how many of y'all know there's always an exception? God has blessed you. And he has told you, you can have this whole world belongs to you. How many of y'all know that? Everything. God said, everything I made it for you. Amen. Amen. You can have it all, but God says there's just a simple rule. I don't want you to sin. Amen. Say, we can go through the examples from every level. We can say to ourselves, well, the Lord said, be ye sober, but Lord, if I just drink a whole lot, don't get drunk. It must be all right. Amen. That's not what God said. Amen. Say, we make up in our minds. We decide. We say, well, you know, a little sex ain't like, you know, ain't no big thing. Hello, somebody. You know, I just got one boyfriend. Amen. This one. When you get him out, amen. Praise God. We believe that a little sin is all right. But with God, all sin is still sin. Amen. He told Adam, he said, Adam, don't eat from that tree. And I love this about Adam because Adam was obedient, amen. He didn't eat from that tree. Adam stayed away from that tree until,
all right,
hello, till Eve showed up. Man is an amazing creature. As soon as one man showed up, he lost all good sense, amen. Praise God, and still do. Say, that's why I tell them all the time. The Bible says when Adam looked over and saw her, he said, whoa, man, amen. I believe that's what he said. He said, whoa, man. And then she became whoa, man. Say, saints, as we go through on this journey, say, God said, Adam, don't do it. But when Eve enticed him to do it, how many of y'all know that other folk can entice you?
Right.
I'm not just talking about the male-female thing, but I'm talking about you and your journey. You know who you are. You know how you ought to live. You know how you ought to act. But because you want to have somebody else like you, you want other folk to call you, hello, somebody. You change what you know you should not do, and you start acting the way they want you to.
All right.
Hello. We do this all the time. I just wanted him to like me. I didn't really want to hang out with them, but I wanted them to like me. Amen. Say, we like to blame it on kids, but I see grown folk. I see 50-year-old folk.
Yeah.
Amen. When I see a full-grown man with his pants down below, hello, I know that you, man, you know better than what you're doing, but you're attempting, hello, to be somebody that you're not. Adam was again doing fine. But when Eve came to him and brought it to him, Adam immediately went on and bent on him too, whatever that fruit was. And then God came, the Bible says he came to Adam. Now I want you to notice this, and I'll really get to my message. That when Eve ate from whatever fruit it was, God didn't charge Eve with that sin. Now I'm going to talk to my men for a minute. When Eve ate from whatever fruit it was, God did not charge Eve with the sin. Why? Because God told Adam. Hello, I ain't got the two men in the church besides me today. I'm talking to you too. Amen. Say, the Lord holds the man accountable for his actions. Hello, somebody. Say amen, man. The Lord has placed you, he put you here in a position of authority. When your house ain't right, God is going to hold you accountable. When your children do not live right, act right, don't go to church, don't know the Lord, he holds you accountable. It is the responsibility of the man. Hello, are you listening to me? Inside the church. That's the rule of the law. God said, Adam, when he came back after the eating of the fruit, the sin against God, he came back into the garden and he said, Adam, where are you? How many of y'all know you can't hide from God? Amen. You need to understand. Say, whatever it is that you're doing, you might get away. The preacher may not know it. The deacon may not know it. The mothers may not know it. Your friends may not know it. But God saw every little thing you did. Whatever you think you got away with, I need you to know. It's written down in the book of life, and God has already read it. One of these days, you're going to have to give an accounting. Nobody saw me. God saw you. Nobody heard me. God heard every word. Didn't nobody else, wasn't nobody else in the room. God He said, Adam, where are you? I can tell you right now, God knew exactly where he was, what he was doing, and how he was doing it. And the word of God went forth in the land and called on Adam. And then, saints, I love this about it. Because Adam comes back and he's got three reasons. Isn't it amazing that no matter how we sin, we always have a reason? No matter what it is, we can explain to God, Lord, listen, if you just give me a moment, I can tell you what happened. Amen. It's really not as bad as it looks. But Adam sits here, looks at God, and he says to him, first off, Lord, I need you to know, I was scared. Yeah. Hello, somebody. I was scared of a God that I had been walking with all my life. I was scared of a God that had touched me and kept me. I was scared of a God who had provided for my every need. So right off the bat, the first thing Adam did was what? Lie. Some of y'all need to know that the first word that come out of your mouth, Mama used to write it down. She tell me whatever it is you say first, he lied. Oh, she knew me good, amen. Whatever it was, whatever word came out of my mouth, she just dismissed that because she said you already lied. And she would wait on me until she knew that I knew that she knew that I was lying. And then the truth would start to trickle out. Adam starts out and he says, first off, Lord, I need you to understand, I was scared. And then the second thing he says, and by the way, not only was I scared, but I didn't have no clothes on. Yeah. Amen? How are you going to tell God that you was naked?
Amen.
Yeah. Whatever it is, God made it. Amen?
Amen?
So ain't no sense in your hiding it from the Lord. Some of y'all need to go ahead on and quit lying to yourself and quit lying to God and expose your sin for what it is. Amen? It is a sin. Quit telling yourself, I can sleep with this man, I can sleep with this woman, it's all right. I can take that money and nobody will know the difference, it'll be all right. I got a head, oh, I love this one. Children, young people, y'all do this one all the time. Look what I found. Listen, baby, if it was in my house on my dresser and you didn't find it, it belonged to somebody. Oh, yeah, I preach to little people right along with everybody else. I need you to know that when you get to school and one of your classmates leaves a book bag, and I don't care if it's got an iPod, an iPad, or anything else in it, it ain't yours. Don't talk about what you found. Hell, it wasn't yours in the first place, and it ought not to be yours when the day is over. What God has for you, that's for you. Amen. Got to preach to children because they got to grow up. Amen. But adults, I need you to hear me on the same thing. Every single pencil that you've ever stole from your job, I use the word stole because that's what you need. Amen. Every little piece of paper, every little bit, somebody else bought it. Amen. Somebody else invested in it. And everything that you take is still theft. A thief is still a thief.
Use me if I want to be called your son or your daughter.
have this thing. He looks at him. God says, Adam, I know what you're doing. God commands. He commanded thee. He said, did you eat from the tree that I told you not to? I remember Mama used to look at me and talk about, boy, was you with them folk that I told you didn't need to be with? You ever been there? Got a warning. Sometimes it ain't mama, sometimes it ain't daddy, sometimes it's the spirit of the Lord that just tells you you're in a company that you ain't got no business being with. Hello? God will speak to your heart. He'll tell you that you should not be associated with this man or that woman or that group of folk, and you still go against the will of God and do it anyway. Saints, there are consequences to your actions. Let me get to it here with Eve. Because here, this is an important point I need you to hear. He spoke with Adam first. Adam then turns around and he says, listen, Lord, the whole problem was that this woman. Amen. 12 verse. He said, Lord, I was doing fine. I was going through the garden. Everything's good. I was talking with the animals. We were having a good time. He said, but then you messed up, Lord.
Right.
He said, that woman that you gave me, it's a legal thing.
Yeah.
I just need you to know, Lord, that it was you that brought her into my realm.
Yeah.
He said, that woman that you gave me. So first he blames it on Eve. And then he turns around and he said, and it was her who went to the tree. I was sitting there, I wasn't doing nothing. I was sitting back, I was in my lounge chair, I was watching television, Big Bang Theory was on, I was doing just fine, but that woman just showed up and she gave me the fruit. Amen. And then he said, and then I ate. After all, you must understand. You gave her to me, and then she gave me the fruit, and I didn't have a choice. How many of y'all know that that's a lie?
Amen.
How many of y'all understand that when it comes down to sin, you always have a choice?
Right.
Amen. You don't have to do wrong in what you're doing. You don't have to sleep with that man. You don't have to take that money. You don't have to run with that crowd. You don't have to. Hello, somebody. I need you to know that you get to make a choice in everything you do in this life. Every opportunity that comes your way, you can choose to ignore it or to accept it. Every time things are headed in one direction or another, you make a choice to go this way or that. You can choose to go up in your life or you can choose to go down. There are folk who have chosen to stay in the same place for the rest of their lives. The reason you ain't got nothing is because you ain't never wanted nothing. You've been happy right where you are. As long as I got a chair, a house, a roof over my head, and someplace to sleep. Since I need you to understand, Jesus said, I came to give you life and life more abundantly. You need to start wanting more, and God will give you more. You got to start wanting, Lord. I don't want just any house. I want the best one that I can get. I don't want just any car. I want the best car I can get in. Because God told me that I can have anything I want. Some of y'all need to start claiming your blessings from the Lord. God wants the blessing. He wants you to have. But you're not accepting because you're settling.
Can
you hear me? You're not getting what God wants for you because you're settling for what you already got. That's why it's a problem with folk when it talks about tithing. Saints, God can't put more money in your pocket when you already got a pocket full. No more. I'm sorry, I had some new bills, but you still got the old ones. So it ain't no sense in me giving them. A lot of us go through in life. That's the reason that we don't have. That's why you're not getting blessed, because you want time. You think that if I hold on to the dollar I got, and if God gives me another one, then I'll have $2. God had already said, you already got one. Why should I give you another? That's the problem as we go through in this life. Praise God. Seven. All right, let me get to it. Not that bad, but I'm not too long. It's a woman's fault. And then look at the woman. I love this. Because the Lord comes to her. And he says, the Lord said unto the woman, what is this that thou hast done? And the woman says, see, I know, ladies, y'all like to blame it on the man. Because the man blamed it on the woman, but look at the woman. As soon as she spoke up, she said, you know what, Lord? It was the serpent. We are good at passing it on to somebody else. It's never your fault. Oh, somebody hear me, because you've been It's never your fault.